Hey, welcome back.
Welcome back.
We have a bit of a hallow situation we're dealing with here. This has escaped its intended bounds, apparently due to vines. There are dreamer ghouls in hallowed underground deserts.
Oh.
I see one here.
All right, let me come take a look. I'm not sure if I've seen that guy.
It confuses me.
Oh, yeah, okay.
I'm gonna hang on the ceiling and let you come here and see it.
All right. I'm gonna take a better look at this guy. Hey, buddy. Dreamer ghoul.
New guide. Our guide died right after the last episode. I don't know if either of us included that.
Indeed. All right, so this is supposed to be Antlion Den, and so I'm using the Contaminator, which costs a pretty penny, but we've got plenty of money at this point.
Mm-hmm.
Try to change it back. The bottom area... Yeah, I'm not sure where the... Is there like a bottom area that's boxed out all the way across? Like, I don't have that on my map.
Party so I can see where you are.
Oh, right. Haha.
Just investigating this. Let's see if I can just mine these out. I see glowy hollow things down there. Is that because I'm just in a hollow biome, or is there more down there?
In any case, meanwhile, you pointed out that the basilisks actually drop the...
Oh yeah, sturdy fossils, yep.
Sturdy fossils, and so you could get the fossil suit, even if you didn't have enough of those that had just kind of spawned in the ground in your world, which is pretty cool. Although not until hard mode, obviously.
June splicers hurt a lot. And are very glitchy. I just got half of one on my screen a moment ago. How are you for solution?
I bought 200 and something, and I still have 191, so...
Okay.
Solution goes a long way. And... Yeah, from the areas that I have lit that are on my map, I've cleared out just about all of it now.
I was trying to dig out this pocket here, but it was larger than I anticipated, so this might need some attention.
All right, so basically I should come to you?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And I think I see some right below me over here, too. Oh, there it is. Okay. And down here. Okay, I think that'll get it all. Let's kill one of these dreamer ghouls while I'm at it, just in case it has any rare drops that we haven't gotten yet.
Alright, over here.
Now I am heading your way.
Oh, that's gonna get to... Oh, man.
I
wish we'd caught this earlier.
Here. Yeah, I never bother... basically never bother trying to partition things, because it never works. I've seen everybody do it in their LP, and everybody fails at it. And so I was like, why bother?
We'll be the first to be successful.
I see. Wow. Something that always strikes me in a lot of your videos is your never-ending optimism. All right. I see some more over here, so I'm going to go get it along the way. Let's be good to do this. Okay. So let's see. There's some.
Not good. You got the bit I was aiming at.
Let's see. Okay, there's a tiny bit there.
So down and to the right of the area that was partitioned was problematic. So over here... let's see, where am I? So pretty much everything that's like down here, down below, to the right, and above will need some attention.
Okay. So it just kind of got in right over here?
Yeah, so that's okay. Better. Like, right along this wall to the right, I know there's some kind of buried deep right here, for example.
Well, there's some to the left. The left is what?
Yes, left also.
Yeah. To the right, I mean, oh, this wall doesn't go down far enough.
Well, no, well, so just to your right now, there's some pearl stone.
Yeah, but I mean, that's the hallow. I mean, that's...
It's not supposed to be.
Oh.
Above is, to the right is not. This is the boundary.
Got it.
And this stuff over here will spread to the land that,
I see. Got it. Okay, yep. I was looking at the wrong spots on the map and kind of had a little bit of the wrong mental model, but...
So hopefully, I'm just going to dig in here just to make sure. But I think we're in better shape now.
Yeah, and I have... An opportunity to go talk to a new traveling merchant. Is this part? I think that should be okay. In any case, that didn't take too long to do, and only took like 100 solution or something. And now that we have a contaminator, that shouldn't be a big deal in the future. We were originally planning to start this episode out in... Oh, Pinky's here! Cool. And the steampunker was killing her. Nice work. She was shooting lasers of some sort. It looked like possibly like the laser rifle or something.
Oh, she has a clockwork assault rifle with high velocity bullets.
I see. Earlier. Okay. I got bubble 14 can be placed.
Oh yeah, that's Party Girl sells those, I think.
Oh yeah, those are blocks that are in this chest. I thought I clicked on the traveling merchant, and I actually clicked on the chest that was behind him. All right, traveling merchant, sake, pad thai, paint sprayer, DPS meter, gypsy robe, and the katana. The gypsy robe is 2 defense, 6% increased magic, and critical strike reduces mana usage by 10%. It was probably around for a long time. I don't remember having seen it in the past, but...
I need to borrow your contaminator. I found another problem.
Here you are, and here is also the solution.
Great.
But as I was starting to say, we were headed to the jungle because we were going to basically try to mine some chlorophyte and also find a good Plantaris bulb that we could set up a good arena for.
Mm-hmm. We have one at home, but it might be a little bit of a pain to fight there.
Yeah, it's too small and she'd just enrage.
Well, yeah, we'd have to dig out a big area and make it a jungle so we wouldn't get any enraging.
Right. And so what are these blocks? Okay, pink gel, right. Hardened pearl sand and pearl... I see, hardened pearl sand, I guess is right from the sandstone that got hallowed. Got it.
So the reason the hallow jumped over was because of vines coming down off of here. This is how I've solved that problem. So that should be fine now.
Let me renew my buffs before I head over towards the jungle, but I think I'm actually headed over there again now.
Nice. Oops.
Nope, I'm headed up into the top story of the marble house because I forgot to press down as I was passing by the stairs.
Ah, yes.
Good times, good times. And we really haven't spent very much time in the jungle in hard mode.
That's true.
And so it's possible that we might discover or uncover some other surprises. There's some hallow up on the surface.
Yeah, I'll get to it in a moment. I'm just making sure everything down here is good.
No? I guess if we kill Plantera, that'll also slow down the spread, so it'll be easier to deal with that stuff.
A wisp in a bottle would be helpful here. Can't get one of those yet, though. I'd be able to peek inside walls and see if there's hallow blocks in there that I can't see.
I guess you could do a little bit of it with my flower petals and meteor staff could possibly get some light shining down.
I know what I should be using. Night owl potion.
That could help as well. Actually, I don't really need to kill you.
Jungling now?
I'm heading down into the jungle and trying to locate some chlorophyte. And I should also buff and heal. Because in the jungle, there are things that will try to kill me. And
speaking
we'll probably
of potions,
be fairly good at it.
If you're looking for chlorophyte, there's a potion that can help you with that, too.
Oh, right. Oh, I found a Plantaris bulb that's really easy to get to.
Oh, neat.
Not accidentally. Whatever it.
Music changes there. That's a good sign.
There's actually... Oh, and here's some life fruit. Yum. I will save it for you, probably, because I think I'm ahead.
Yeah.
Oh, interesting. I got a soul of light down here. Oh, I see. There's some hallow.
Mm-hmm. Oh, right. The jungle was the original hallowed area, so that's that part's fine.
Right. This looks like... Yeah, I guess that could be part of the house strip. Or it might have been from a smashed demon altar that just put a little bit in here. Because it was kind of on a little island that I was seeing it.
Where is my partition exactly? Right here? That's not good enough.
Aha! That looks like chlorophyte. Aha! Achievement complete. Photosynthesis.
Neat.
Okay, so, yes, if I had gotten a spelunker potion, that would have been clever. But chlorophyte, we have a lot of lit up jungle over here, and so it seems like it's kind of easy to see. I might even have, I probably have spelunker potions in my piggy bank. Why don't I take a look at that? Money trough, show me what you got. Spelunker potion, 22. Yeah, let's use the spelunker potion. Hey, life root. Oh, it shows off the life root too, right. Ha! Oh. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. So yeah, when you're done contaminating, I do think that the plantera that is kind of right near the entrance to the jungle over here will be a good one, because it's near a good bit of open space. And so...
I'm trying to see it on the map.
It's...
Where are you?
Above the... There's a elevator kind of near there, and it's basically near that. I don't know how well I'm describing it.
It is? Okay, I see that. Must not be showing up on my map.
All right, I'll go ahead and go back over there and make sure it's... What is that? Oh, that's my money trough. I was like, I see something pink, but it's not... It's not Plantera.
Mm-hmm. All right, just double-checking my contamination here.
Hi, Lafer.
There's a bit that escaped.
Yum, yum, yum. All right, so... Where was it that I saw Plantera again? Let me get mud on my bar, I think, because I'll want to kind of, like, fill some of these things back in. As I'm going, I expect... Okay, I see Plantera's right above me over here, right? Yes. Can you see where I am on the map right now?
Probably yes.
Okay, Plantera is right next to you. Yeah.
Okay, so it does not show up on my map until I've actually seen it.
Oh, okay, it is on my map. Okay, yep. Okay, neat. I really do wish that there was a way in multiplayer to do some kind of map sharing.
Mm-hmm.
But oh well, what you gonna do? Even with the pickaxe axe, chlorophyte still takes a little bit of work to mine.
Oh yeah, it's the first one that can mine it.
And yeah, I'm basically gonna start setting up some heart lanterns and campfires around here, and then trying to get a sense of what else we may need.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't think to bring honey, unless that's also in my piggy bank. It might be in my piggy bank.
I can get some. I'm not too far from. I'll go home, get some, and then wormhole to you.
Okay.
After I finish what I'm doing here, there's always... It does kind of seem like there's always more to do.
Yes, this game is full of distractions. Heal. Ah, quit shooting me things. Alex, the things are not being nice. Ah, cut it out! Oh my gosh, I'm gonna die. I don't want to die. I want to live.
Yeah, jungle's nasty. I see your 8 health.
7. 6.
Do I need to bring you a Bezoar?
5. Oh, it's gonna be so close.
2?
If you wormhole, otherwise you're gonna miss your chance.
Oh, you made it.
Oh, oh wow, one yeah. Health. I thought I saw the time ticking down. Hopefully I don't have, like, what is it, feral bite?
Mm-hmm.
That would be really bad.
Oh, I'll just randomly give you poison or something?
Right. All right, my potion sickness is about to wear off. Okay. And there's a campfire over there. Let's go ahead, since I have so many heart lanterns, let's throw a heart lantern over here as well. Okay. That was really close.
Yep.
All right, we need more campfires.
Okay, I think this hollow is contained. It's just so hard to know for sure.
And I don't want all that water to spill out. Well, that water's all spilling out now, so in for a penny, in for a pound.
Contaminator's going in other equipment for now.
All right. What else do I have? Right, the yo-yo is a good way to attack you at range. Yeah, I don't have a lot of practice in the jungle, and I don't know that I'm doing a great job right now staying alive. And I'm not being kind of careful at all in terms of how I'm placing these heart lanterns and campfires. I'm just trying to get them kind of all around the area where the Plantaris bulb is.
So I'm bringing you honey. Let's see, where have I stuck honey buckets?
Okay, and so then the other thing we're going to need is space. Let me put some stuff up here too. And remind me to hand you some life fruit, and I should eat some life fruit before we before we get into any tangles up here.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go over here.
Have eaten some life fruit.
Oh, congratulations. Alright, so you're up to what's 420?
425.
I see. Alright, so you can have this. I will eat these. Yum, yum. Thanks for the honey.
Mm-hmm.
Plantera is just kind of up and to the right. But.
So let me look at my map now and see if. So if I'm here. Alright, you're there. I'm going to go see the bulb, and now it shows up. Weird.
Hmm.
Yeah, so I guess there are some elements in this game where the map will not show you if you haven't actually seen them on screen. Plantera's
right.
Bulb is one of them. Unless I was just looking in the wrong spot this whole time, but I don't think I was. Yeah, this... Okay, the way this space is set up is going to bring lots and lots and lots of spawns to
yes,
us.
Yes, I'm thinking we should, like, box out... Like, we should figure out where our fighting space is and then box
yep.
the rest out.
Oh, wow. I was nearly dead and I didn't realize it.
Oh, yeah, be sure you're buffed. Actually, my buffs ran out. Just with, you know, iron skin regen, whatever. Yeah, I didn't bring other, like, awesome boss fighting buffs. I didn't think about that.
I'm gonna go back and get some peace candles and sunflowers.
I have those in my, peace candles I have in
or
my, what do you call? I've only got four of them, but I'll go ahead and just put them out. Do they have to be on platforms, I think?
Possibly. Probably.
Okay. Just throw out a peace candle. I'll try to do it kind of in four quadrants around Plantera. There's one, there's one. There's one.
Oh, why didn't you give me the thing I wanted?
I got another medicated bandage, by the way.
Oh, good.
So that's... Yeah, having to get two of everything for the Ankh Charm is definitely going to be...
By medicated bandage, do you mean Bezor?
No, I mean the medicated bandage.
Oh, okay. So I
Yeah, we still need another Bezor.
So I just handed you a medicated bandage a moment ago.
Oh, maybe you handed it to me and I didn't
yeah,
get
it. Yeah, it's not a thing that drops.
Got it. All right, let me actually put it in my thing so I can do that.
See, I came here to give that to you so you can survive. Now I'm having poison troubles.
I see.
That's okay, though.
All right, so I've got some peace candles.
Extra 5 life I just got will help.
Kind of in the nearest area, and now let me figure out where I want to box out. I'm not sure how big is a big enough arena.
I'll take a look. Is it already dug out partially?
I mean, basically, it's near a bit of open space. It's not great, though. Let me...
For a Plantaria, you usually want, like, almost a screenful's worth of space.
Yeah. I'm gonna leave kind of one obstacle in the middle, because sometimes it's useful for dodging her shooting fire kind of things, to be able to dodge around the center. Heal, buff. Oh, gosh. Oops.
Oh. All right, you must have already gotten all the chlorophyte around here, because I'm not finding any.
Yeah, I spent a little time mining around there before. Let's see. While I'm here...
I guess I'd probably see more if I took a Spelunker potion.
Things.
Look at all these souls, though.
Yeah, it feels like there's still going to be a bit of work over there. Okay, I'm just going to head back over there.
Ooh, I found explosives. With a detonator, so those aren't always... Definitely are not always just traps, no?
When you say with a detonator...
I mean with a detonator?
Like a plunger kind of thing, you mean? Okay, as opposed to, yeah. But I guess that's... Is that possibly the first time we've seen that outside of a, like, minecart rail place?
Could have been. I don't have any Spelunker potions in my piggy bank, because I thought I did.
Okay.
You
I
have
20-something, and so... Okay. Oh, I can wormhole, huh? Right, that's not how you use a wormhole potion, Brian.
Oh, apparently I put you in a bad place.
I didn't visit the nurse, because I was like, it's going to take me a while to walk back, and by the time I do... Right. All right, so Spelunker potions. Oh, I have not even summoned my dudes to come help us. Okay, Spelunker potions. I have a bunch of Spelunker potions.
Great. All right, there's some chlorophyte.
And, yeah, I was just back home, and I had a bunch of chlorophyte in my inventory, and I didn't even think to, like, talk to the guy to see if there's any new obvious stuff. Oh, gosh.
Yeah.
Maybe I'll go do that right now.
For a second, I thought that was a death message.
Oh, boy. Have you already talked to the guy about chlorophyte? I can't remember.
Nope, I haven't.
All right.
I just mined my first chlorophyte a moment ago.
Crafting. Chlorophytes. 6 of them turn into a bar, so that's still the case. There are now chlorophyte bricks that you craft with stone. That look like they might be kind of attractive. They're bright and green.
Oh, 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 jungle key.
What? Say that again.
I am jungle key.
You got a key, not a key mold, but a key?
Oh, yeah. Are there no longer key molds?
Interesting.
Is it like a rare drop for the key? I'm going to come home.
We should go to the dungeon and go get that right now.
Yes, indeed.
Wow. Wow!
So come home. I want to get some souls just to see if the molds still exist. So soul of fright, for example.
I'm going to lose these, so let me favorite these.
You've gone super quiet for some reason.
Oh, I might have just been mumbling. Can
you
hear me?
Yeah, kind of. Okay, the souls of light do not any longer go into key molds, so I think it's just keys that drop, no?
Interesting. Okay. I'm going to adjust my mic a tiny bit here.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to drop off a few more potion ingredients down here, and then, yeah, let's go back to the dungeon. I'm going to also take a quick look on the dungeon map, because I believe, did we put the letters next to, like, with torches? Yes, H, C, I.
Oh yeah, those letters.
J is at the very bottom left of the jungle, or different jungle dungeon.
All right, I'm gonna go there and get that stuff.
Yeah, I'm gonna go with you to make sure that we live to get that stuff.
I mean, the dungeon is still easy mode.
Oh, that's right. All right, then I will continue to go work on the Plantera Arena.
Cool.
Oh, Piranha Gun, I'm so jealous.
Yeah, it's going to be fun. It's been a long time since I had one of those.
Assuming that that's... I imagine that that's still what's inside of it, but...
I actually have never had one when I was built as a ranger, so this will be cool.
Oh, that's right, you were a magic character in the playthrough that you got it the first time, weren't you?
I gave up on the other one before I got as far as the jungle key.
All right, interesting. So if there's no key molds, I wonder if that ocean farm will work and just drop all the keys now?
Probably. I mean, if it works at all, then it'll just drop keys instead of molds.
Right.
That's weird because they changed it from keys to molds, but then they decided to change it back, I guess.
Right. I think they changed it from keys to molds because they didn't want you to get it before you killed Plantera, but now obviously you can again. Yeah, I don't know.
Or before you killed the three hard mode bosses, maybe they changed it so they only drop after that.
Oh, yeah, maybe you have to kill all three before the keys start dropping, and so that's why we never saw any of them in the ocean farm before.
Mechanical, that's the word I wanted. Yeah.
That sounds pretty plausible, so maybe now if I went to the ocean farm... I'm kind of curious about that now.
Since the life fruit changed, then I could definitely see drop chances changing too.
Yes. Okay, I'm going to continue past the jungle and just go, like, run the ocean farm for 5 minutes just to see if, by any chance, a bunch of keys start dropping, because I'm really curious about that now.
This dungeon needs a elevator.
It has one that goes just...
like, nowhere near the entrance.
It still might be the fastest way down. Actually, with the pickaxe axe, you could almost dig one.
Yeah, I think yours, the one you're talking about, is in the right place.
Yeah, it's on the left-hand side, kind of,
The entrance is, like, a long way from the part of the dungeon that goes down. All right, J, on my map, is right there.
Fascinating. So you just get those keys. Yeah, it's got to be that the keys only start dropping after you've killed the mechanical bosses, I'm guessing, because otherwise those weapons are so overpowered, assuming, you know, they haven't changed. Well, overpowered for the beginning of hard mode.
Yeah, pretty good.
That it would be appropriate to do something to make sure you can't get them too early.
Splunker potion is showing me so many things down here. It's a gem cave just off to the side. Little thing with a life crystal and some other stuff in it up here.
Let's see, how does this work? I guess I want to do that. And is there something else that I do? Already got a water candle over here. We have the jungle music playing. Right, except for I need to decide what type of key I want to get.
Oh, you're at the ocean farm, I see.
Right.
For you, I'm guessing Rainbow Rod might be one of the most interesting ones. Did we ever figure out how to get the Hallow there to work? Did we place enough Pearl Stone? Because there was a problem where we couldn't get the music.
I did not remember that, but I just placed another block, and sure enough... I don't seem to be getting... Oh no, what did I just place? That's red ice block. That's crimson. That's not what I want. So for the Hallow... Right, yeah, we placed all this Pearl Stone and the music never changed. Yeah, that's a good question. All right, I think I could do... I guess, do we have a... We don't have a corruption key... Or corruption chest. So the corruption key wouldn't be useful, I guess, in this world.
I don't think you'll even be able to get it.
Right. So vampire knives, I guess, is the only other possibility. And so if I do...
So ice for Frost Hider would be useful for both of us. Although we'd have to trade back and forth. That could be annoying. So that's probably just for you then.
Okay, so...
Only 300. I'm surprised. I would have thought we'd have fought more of those.
We probably fought more.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I got something called Forceful Yellets. Hold on.
Is it a yo-yo?
That would make sense. Let's see. It is a yo-yo. 63 melee damage, which is better than the current yo-yo I'm using. Fast speed, weak knockback. Neat.
Oh. I got a layout down here without having checked the tooltip of this. Jungle key. It has been cursed by a powerful jungle creature. I cannot use it on the chest.
Oh, okay.
So you still have to defeat Plantera.
Okay. I just got another Yelitz.
Yelit, you're saying?
Let me... Actually, after I get the ocean farm going again, read the name of it more carefully again. Y-E-L-E-T-S is the name of it.
Yelitz.
So I'm going to say Yelitz. Interesting. So I wonder if this yo-yo possibly also only appears after defeating mechanical bosses or something, just because... Mm-hmm. Yeah, we hadn't gotten it before, and I've already gotten two to drop at the ocean farm now. I feel like there was one other thing I was doing to make monsters spawn faster and get over here, but I don't remember what it was, so I won't worry about it now.
So right. So while you're over there, mm-hmm. Should I bring you some pearl stone? Would that, if I bring you more pearl stone, I'm having trouble phrasing the thing I'm trying to ask.
I mean, I don't know if it would help, because it seems like we already have a ton, but, yeah, I don't know.
So, you have used all the pearl stone you have, and it has not created the howl music, right?
Correct.
Okay.
Although, I thought before I was getting it to turn to the crimson music, and it's also not turning to the crimson music over here.
I'm wondering if things are canceling each other out, like if you have a bunch of hallow blocks near a bunch of... crimson blocks, they like fight each other and
that's
won't trigger either
interesting.
One.
Interesting, then I hadn't thought about that. Yeah, sorry they picked an inopportune time.
Yeah, the chilled water is annoying. Alright, so ocean music, lots of hallow. I'm going to... Yeah, because these are like equal amounts of hallow and corruption crimson blocks. I'm going to try...
Take down all the corruption and crimson and see if the hallow appears.
Did I hear...
There's jungle to the left.
If I go up here, I can hear hallow music. If I go over here, I hear jungle music. Then over here, I hear ocean music. So it's like, yeah, all the biomes are fighting it out, apparently. Game just doesn't know what to do.
I'm not getting any hallow music. How'd you get the hallow music?
Up here.
Oh. Oh, yeah. Okay, yeah. All right, I'm going to try taking down the Crimson Encryption then and see if we can get the Hallow. All right, this is not at all what we plan to do today, but...
We set up a Plantera arena.
Kind of. It still needs the honey and a little bit more open space.
Okay, I hear Hallow when I'm standing right here now.
Okay, so it's improving. I still don't hear it.
Yeah, moving over here, I hear jungle.
Yeah, I've got just totally jungle right now.
I'm guessing actuators wouldn't actually deactivate these blocks for the biome. Yeah, no, that wouldn't make sense. So I hear jungle here.
So maybe does the jungle music override the hallow music, possibly?
Oh, it would, because we have a hallowed jungle and plays jungle music.
I see.
So if the jungle is on screen, I hear that instead.
So yeah, the music is not necessarily reliable, which we kind of already knew. But in
I still hear jungle here, but that's fine. I hear hallow just over here.
Right, so presumably...
The water, though, the water should turn purple is the thing.
Oh, yeah, and I'm getting hallow music, over here. Hmm.
Does the ocean water ever turn purple? I'm not sure I haven't seen hallowed ocean before.
There's another Amarok. I think I actually said it the right way this time.
Yep.
And, yeah, lots of loot, but no obvious keys. What else did I get? Anything useful? Okay, I guess the Hurtful Yelitz is better, because it deals more damage. 69 melee damage, very nice. Let me actually try it, too. I didn't see if it's... Mm-hmm. I guess underwater, if it were doing, like, on-fire debuffs or different things, I might not see them. Let me go kill somebody who's not underwater and just see if this inflicts any debuffs. Oh, perfect, a goblin. Doesn't appear that it does. It's a little bit more tattered cloth. Did you set up a timer at the beginning of this episode?
Yes.
All right.
We still have a little bit of time.
Should we...
Or actually, not much.
Should we... I was going to say, should we try Goblins or Pantera, or maybe we'll just
those will take too long, I think.
Okay. In that case...
I am no longer getting chilled in this water.
Right, because I took away... there's an ice biome at the top left still, right? Or did you take that one
away? So you took down the red ice. Maybe that was contributing to...
Right, overall iciness or something?
I think what we've learned is we don't know how this thing works.
Yeah. I think that sounds like a good assessment of the state of the world. All right. Well, we know that we can get keys. We don't know
how to... can't use them yet.
How to farm them. And yeah, I guess Plantera, yeah, I guess it'll still be a very high priority then. And so I guess we'll try to do Plantera before we try to do the goblins next episode.
Sure, sounds reasonable.
And yeah, still just hoping that I'm going to get lucky over here, but I guess now I'm just an ocean, and so...
I'm going to go do the thing you usually do and check for life fruits down here.
All right. Interesting. All right, well, I'll try to read up about this off camera at some point and see if there is a good way to set up a farm. Oh my gosh, crab banner. My inventory is filled with stuff. Ending.
All right, if you're done, I guess we'll see everybody next time.
Yep. Plantera battle ahead, I'm sure of it.
Yep. Can't be sure of success, but battle probably.
Indeed.